Medium the game is getting vastly overlooked, and it really shouldn't be. This is Fab Live every day except Tuesdays and Thursdays over on Twitch, link down below. Let's discuss why I think this game should be paid more attention and why it's flying under the radar. From developer Blooper Team, known for games such as Layers of Fear and Blair Witch, they have garnered a solid reputation for themselves in the horror genre. With the initial release date meant to be December 4th and it being pushed back into January 28th, a Windows and Series X and S timed exclusive, most likely around 6 to 8 months until PlayStation owners will be able to get their hands on this title. However, one quick benefit is if you do have Game Pass, it is coming date and date. So if you are a subscriber, go ahead and pre-install so you're ready when the game comes out. With an exclusive interview with Gaming Bolt producer Jack Ziba, I think I'm saying his name right, I don't know. If I got it wrong, I apologize. However, he revealed that the game will be around 8 to 10 hours long, which, in my opinion, is the ideal length. Working a full-time job, streaming, YouTube, family, friends, time can be hard to come by, so I usually prefer my experiences medium in length, see what I did there, with a great story and a great gameplay loop. One of the biggest draws to the medium is the dual reality gameplay, where they simultaneously render two worlds at the same time and split the screen so you see both perspectives. It's been confirmed that you'll be in this mode roughly about 33% of the time, which the out-of-body ability enabling you to move through a single plane when in the other dimension is kind of bound by limitations. For me, this mode is the greatest selling point, at least personally, because I think it creates such an amazing aesthetic, and being such a big fan of like the Silent Hill franchise, I think this really adds a nice twist to the survival horror game. So where is all the hype for this game? I'm surprised how quiet it is about this game. It may be due to Blooper's previous games. For me, example, I wasn't a fan of either of them. Scoring an average on 70 in Metacritic seems like they weren't the most beloved, which could be tempering some expectations. However, me on the other hand, I'm pretty excited. It may be due to the bias or my love for Silent Hill and all the resemblance between those two games.
James, honey, did something happen to you? After we got separated in that long hallway? Are you confusing me with someone else? You were always so forgetful. Remember that time in the hotel? You said you took everything, but you forgot that videotape we made. I wonder if it's still there. I'm not your Mary.
However, the creature design, the world aesthetic is enough to draw me in. I do have my concerns though. It's not a full retail price coming in at $49.99, meaning probably had less of a budget and probably would be considered a AA game. Along with the combat not being shown one bit, it seems obvious that this won't be quite down the hill of Resident Evil and Evil Within, but more of a puzzle adventure in the horror sphere, which I'm totally fine with as long as it's done well. A lot of the time, puzzles tend to be too easy or mundane, so as long as they have variety and challenge, we should be in for a good treat. So, what are your thoughts on the medium? Are you excited or you don't care? Leave a comment down below and leave a subscribe if you're enjoying the content. Let's hit that 1K mark together. Thank you again for all the love and support throughout the years, everybody. And until next time, have a good one. Peace.